Greetings. 2 Timothy 2:15. Study to show thyself approved unto God, a workman that needeth not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. But shun profane and vain babblings, for they will increase unto more ungodliness. The previous scripture is important. It is a command to study the word of God, with the following consequence: rightly dividing the word of truth. The implication is that if you do not study, you will not rightly divide the word of truth. You will wrongly divide the word of truth. I want you to understand a basic contributor to this problem: reading only some of the word of God. If you think about it, this is what you see from Mohammedans. They only read parts of passages and they ignore the context. Well, this is a universal failure of all who try to justify their position by only quoting a few scriptures to support their dogma. If you love the truth, you must strive to study, to learn all the scriptures that pertain, that are relevant. Only then do you begin to see the whole picture, the whole teaching. And you can create quite a list of teachings where it is based on half the scriptures that apply. Predestination. Just read half the scriptures and you can be Calvinist. Read the other half and you'll be an Arminian. Pre-trib rapture. Half the scriptures support pre-trib. Some speak of overcoming. The welfare state? Read only the verses that teach giving or curse the rich. Don't judge? Read only the part of the verse that says, judge not. The real challenge is to study and research and find out what the holistic message of the prophets is. Holistic. Characterized by comprehension of the parts of something as intimately interconnected and explicable only by reference to the whole. Think about the story of the elephant and five blind men. They all described only the portion they came into contact with. That is the challenge we face as Christians. In order to be workmen who don't need to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. The implication of rightly dividing is that if you do not study, you will wrongly divide the word of truth. So take to heart that you need to study, and you need to research and examine all the scriptures that apply. Be a good Berean. Acts 17:11. And the people of Berea were more open-minded than those in Thessalonica. And they listened eagerly to Paul's message. They searched the scriptures day after day to see if Paul and Silas were teaching the truth. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.